about gentrification?
Gentrification, my God. You're like fish swimming in water. You can't even see it anymore. It's gotten so far. We are here tonight speaking. We're here tonight on the anniversary of the Tompkins Square Park riot.
Police
riot. August 6th and 7th, 1988. The big one. Everybody remember the Tompkins Square Park riot of 19... Who remembers that?
I have one there.
Police went wild.
Yeah.
Police started it. I remember it.
That said gentrification's class war was on the fence of Tompkins Square Park as the cops were chasing people down at random and beating them up because they were trying to curfew Tompkins Square Park. There was not a curfew there, so they could kick homeless people out of the park. Homeless people were living in the park. Why were homeless people living in Tompkins Square Park?
Good question.
Anyone know why homeless people were living in
the
park?
Yeah, but the city shelter system was like worse than a jail.
There you go. It was like a jail. People wanted a little dignity and they wanted a little community. So they were living in Tompkins Square Park. First they were in City Hall Park. Then they moved up to Tompkins Square Park. Then the right wing in the neighborhood went crazy and tried to organize a whole movement to get them out and called in the cops. And people like squatters and neighborhood activists defended the homeless people, defended all of our rights to have an open park where we could sit there during the summer at night when it was hot like it had happened for 100 years. You know? And we had a big fight with the cops. We had a big riot. And the cops beat up. Come on, folks, this is a quiz. Let's see, you know.
About 160 people.
160 people at least.
You know the answer.
Were beaten up that night by cops going wild. They walked into 7A, the restaurant. They ran after the manager of the restaurant and beat her up. People were standing around with blood dripping down their bald pates that were just all bleeding. And we started to all get together after that. I personally ran into the squatters at the Lower East Side at that point, and that changed my life. And we had a movement with event after event and protests. We had riots because the cops tried to stop concerts in the park. We sat in at Betsy Gottbaum's office uptown when they took down the fan shell that had been built in the 60s for community cultures that were free space to perform. Now you have to have hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars to rent a space for the city to perform in Tompkins Square Park. That was a symbol of free speech. We fought to protect that. We had conferences. We defended community gardens. We fought. We had protests against the first Gulf War. On and on and on. It changed my life. Whose life else did it change this year?
It's mine.
The Tompkins Square riot in 1988. So this is like the 23rd anniversary.
Yes, it is.
And we do something. We do something to commemorate that riot every year because that was a righteous riot. A righteous riot. And we were fighting back. And I joined up with people I met that night because they were fighting back. Because already hordes of people from refugees from shopping malls or whatever were just storming the neighborhood, paying outrageous rents. The rents were going up and up and up. When I moved into this neighborhood, I got an apartment for $64 a month. Okay, it was a long time ago. But the rents should not have been going into the thousands, which they are today. If rents had gone up normally, you know, not that I like the whole rent system, but if they'd gone up a couple of hundred a year, like it happened for years, we would all be paying maybe $500, $600. But no. The people above me, I'm in rent control apartment, thank goodness, that's why I'm here. The people above me are paying $1,200 for the same damn apartment, and that's a small studio. So you can't move into this neighborhood anymore. You've got to be a stockbroker to live here.
Mm.
And this was the place for artists, for political activists, for the interesting
Lou
people.
Lou Reed, Patti Smith, Abby Hoffman.
My God,
the list goes on. Jean-Claude Basquiat. None of those people would have existed and been able to create, become what they were if it wasn't for the cheap rents in this neighborhood. Now you don't get any creativity because the assholes that have moved into this neighborhood are a bunch of fucking people with money.
Right.
They're mostly white people.
Right.
And if you notice, gentrification, anywhere you go in the world, it's the white upper class doing the gentrifying.
Right.
They come into ethnically mixed neighborhoods. They take a little bit, the next thing you know, there's more of them, then the next thing you know, that's all that's there. And that's pretty much what's happening over here on the Lower East Side. And you won't find any of this creativity anymore. You won't find a Lou Reed, a Patti Smith,
a Julie Cooper,
an Abby Hoffman, a Julie Cooper, Allen Ginsberg, Herbert Hunky. The list goes on and on. You won't find that come out of this crowd of people because they don't give a fuck.
What?
Well, look, Madonna came down and went, it was cheap rent. She fucked every Puerto Rican on my block, but what can I say?
So what do we do when we have no place to live anymore and our only option is to take some corporate job? They don't give it to us probably because we don't have the resume. We could maybe sweep the floors of the corporate buildings. And you know, if you can't rent an apartment on that salary, what the hell do we do?
Well, I think we need a revolution in this country, but I don't think it's going to happen. It is happening to some degree by people like my friend here, who is been raided by the FBI for being allegedly associated with the group Anonymous, who recently hacked the FBI, hacked NATO, hacked 70 law enforcement agencies across the country, getting ready to release that information that they got. They're going to release the names of confidential informants, the names and home phone numbers and addresses of all the police. They've hacked the city of Orlando. The list goes on. They are young, and they are a hope for the future because they know what the fuck they're doing, and I think it's a good thing, and this man right here is one of them.
Yeah.
So we do have something going on. Although spending $6 million for something like this, I'm not exactly sure what it is. I don't think they know what it is. I definitely know from the pictures I saw of the crowd that was here for opening night that none of those people look very fucking uncomfortable. In fact, they look like a bunch of white Upper West Side art patrons,
right,
who are very comfortable because they have a lot of money. Those are exactly the type of people we don't want that ruin this neighborhood, that started coming down here and opening bars and buying real estate. The people that came for the opening of this space are the enemy to us. Whether you like it or not, they are the people that ruined this neighborhood. Joy.